points, our next point is proportion. The proportion is a statement that two ratios are equal. The proportion is a statement that two ratios are equal. Now, students, look at here. 4 is to be 8 and 8 is to be 16. So now, are they equal? Let us check. 4 upon 8, 8 upon 16 is equal to 1 upon 2 and is equal to 1 upon 2. Now, what is the answer? 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2. So they are equal. So they are in proportion. Clear it with everyone? If two ratios are equal, then we can say that the proportion is statement that two ratios are equal. So they are in a proportion. Clear everyone? Now students, symbol of a proportion is equal to or in this is. These two are the symbols of proportion. Now A is to B and C is to be D. Now students, B and C are called middle terms. Middle terms and the other name is mean. Okay? Means. Now A and D, these are extreme terms. Okay? Outside A and D are called extreme terms. Next, what is the formula? Product of extreme is equal to product of means or middle terms. Both are the same thing, right? Product of extreme is equal to product of means. Now, A divided by B is equal to C upon D. So now, A multiply D and B multiply C. Do cross multiplication. Okay? So A multiply D is equal to B multiply C. Now students, if AD is equal to BC, if AD is equal to BC, then we can say that A, B, C, D are in a proportion. Clear? One example I told you. Okay? And according to that, AD multiply AD is equal to BC, then we can say that A, B, C, D are in proportion. Now look at here. Types of proportion. Right? So first, continued proportion, mean proportional, and third proportional. Now look at here. Continued proportional, according to that, what is that? A is to be B. B is to be C. Now students, it is called continued proportional. Means, look at here. 4 is to be 8 and 8 is to be 16. So 8 equal. When in this way, middle terms are same, at that time we call that they are continued proportional. Okay? It is continued proportional. Now, mean proportional. What is that? Mean proportional. A is to be B and B is to be C. In that proportion, BB is the same. So only B is called mean proportional. Clear? Only B is called mean proportional because in both ratio, B is same. Next, third proportional. A is to be B and B is to be C. So now students, C is third proportion. Last term is C. So when the term is continued proportional, the term is in continued proportional, when C is called third proportion. Now, let us know the relation between this. If this proportion is continued proportion, so B is called mean proportional and C is called third proportional. Clear everyone? But one condition there, the proportion must be continued. Okay? Now let us example. Look at here. 4 is to be 8 and 8 is to be 16. So here in this ratio, 8, 8 equal. Okay? 8, 8 equal. Middle terms are equal. That is why we can say that the given ratios are in proportion. Okay? What is the condition to make the proportion continue? Middle terms must be same. Okay. Now using the continued proposal, mean proposal is which number is same? Same? 8. So B is equal to 8. Mean proportional. So here according to this ratio, mean proportional is 8. And according to this ratio, what is third proposal?